Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. And my name is Sveta Smirnova, and I work as MySQL support engineer for quite a long time. For so quite long time that I remember, then MySQL User Manual contains warning about using asynchronous replication in built-in MySQL asynchronous replication in active mode is not supported and not recommended for use. But what I do not remember a big number of companies who followed this advice. Eventually, this advice was removed from the user manual because MySQL developers and MySQL documentation writers accepted that fact that people used this way, and world did not end. But sometimes I still see this advice on in different places where people recommended for others to don't do it. And here is my talk, is review, it's why we still, while we have this in year 2020, and what is really dangerous using active with asynchronous MySQL replication, and why do we need these active setups when we have synchronous clusters such as Galera or InnoDB cluster. First is what is the issue with asynchronous replication. So let's remind ourselves how it works. So first is slave. It's initiates actually replication. It asks for update from a master to apply it on its side. Master reads this update from binary logs and sends the packet. Slaves, it's actually that's all. At this time, master doesn't know if slave received packet. And even if it's received, if it's stored, it's the packet was stored successfully. And if it was stored successfully, it was not, was updated happening or not. It also doesn't know if updated is happening, even if it updated without error. Was it like actually that update which is same date on master? There are options which allow some control. In first year versions of MySQL, there was only statement-based replication, so it's practically was like you wrote statements. It's no matter it was executed same way on slave. In version 5.1, we have row-based replication. Then MySQL ensures that exactly the row which you want to update is updated. Using primary key and the way to identify it. In version 5.6, we have global transaction IDs, which also prevent users from applying same transaction twice. But it still doesn't answer on the question, so what is, was it, it's just ans- it's just like these protections help to ensure that transactions came and transactions applies its same row as on master, but it doesn't actually, we still don't know if it was successful. It was not like some kind of error, like for example if master and slave table definitions are different. So what happens, it's like it's a problem for what we just described, it's problem for even active passive configuration. But what happens with two active nodes? With two active nodes we have more issues. Let's first, we have two nodes, and we try to insert a row with same ID. It's 42. That's once insert happens, they both send updates to each other. They both receive the update, apply that update, and both nodes get a duplicate key error because they already inserted this row. And that's time replication stops. In case of delete, it happens similar things. So we are trying to fix a previous error. We are deleting this error. Restarting replication, sending updates, receiving updates, and now we are getting key not found error. But this is actually not, things are recoverable because in the same time, at that time, DBA can come in and decide what to do. But in case of update, we may end up with worse situation. In this case, we are having update set different value for the same row. Again, we are exchanging the updates. And now we are having at node 1, which originally said ID I equal 42, we are having value coming from node 2, and on node 2 we are having value coming from node 1. And this is, which is worse, it's data corruption. It's data corruption, it can get not noticed. And then it can lead to forfeit errors when we update the same table, and we actually have data which we don't know which data we have. So in this case, so why to write to multiple nodes? Why people need it? So why don't just write to one? So it's a case, there are many scenarios, and like again, as a support engineer, I'm trying like sometimes something which looks for you crazy, it sometimes it's actually have very good business reason. It's like it may have like each node can have its own purpose, like for different use by different applications. It's possible to use multiple machines for better scalability. I put here a word read because writes needs to be updated on all nodes so that we cannot scale writes this way. But we can read from multiple nodes and we can distribute a lot this way. Nodes can be in different geographical regions. And for example, in Belgium and Brazil, it can be delayed, can be network connection can be interrupted, and sometimes you cannot rely on a Brazil server to get data in Belgium or relatively fast. Sometimes you just need hot standby. This safest way to use active-active setup. So it's practically set as active-active, but temporarily it doesn't accept any writes and reads, while active nodes, it accepts everything, and then it dies, hot standby comes into place. Only a thing with this setup, which is almost safe, is you should not like in case like for example in case of recovery you should be make sure that they do not writes don't go to both service at the same time like for a short period of time, for example when this server comes back, so it should be done like with MySQL, like proxy SQL and some another tool which can distribute balance. We also have in 2020 we have asynchronous solution. I put them here. It will give you very short overview. It's actually which is to our topic. I don't explain difference between them. And but what is the issue with fully synchronous cluster? So in this case we are getting like update on node one, send the packet to other nodes. They receive the packet, applies change, it confirms. And actually, node 1, it's updated, still waits, ready for new update. Of course, you can do updates in multiple threads, so that doesn't mean so that's full server start, full node start. But that's update, its client waits for this answer before continue. So this is sometimes this is takes too long, and sometimes it's not acceptable for application, especially on geo-distributed locations. So it's actually its penalty, its speed of slowest member. So like if it's writes or reads should wait. Tunable, it's actually tunable for parallel reads and writes, but not for the client which is performing update. And what is most important is like if geo replication, like in the servers in different countries, in different cities, that synchronization, you either should accept that synchronization will take a lot of time and have to wait, your applications have to wait, or nodes will, and also nodes may often disconnect in case like because of changing data between data centers, exchanging data between data centers is more risk prone than exchanging data in single data center. Okay, so what we need, how to set up safe asynchronous master. At first, I did not have it on slides, but I assume you do not use bad practices. It's usually it's in the user manual, it's called unsafe statements. That's like using update with limit but without order by. It's like insert ignore and things like this. I assume it's like row-based replication and row-based replication and GTID is also protection. Protection field, but I won't cover this here because it's also true for active passive and actually should be used this way. So actually most important thing for active is you need to divide and rule. It's based on either business logic or database objects. So let's see it for example. So for example, it's very easiest way. It's you can just agree that each server should write to its own set of tables or databases. Like this yellow nodes writes only to this, and these are replicated. And same for orange node, which writes only here, and these are replicated. This way you don't have you won't be able to yellow node won't be able to corrupt this data and orange node won't be able to corrupt this data. So this is relatively safe. For tables, sometimes you have to write into multiple nodes, into active nodes, into same table. In this case, it's a little bit harder and it's more error prone, but you just need to see agreement on which rows to write. For example, yellow node writes to even rows with even ID, and orange node writes to ID. It's easy using after increment. It's after increment you have to set it's number of servers and after increment offset. I put here server ID, but it's not server ID. It should be if you have two servers, so it should be for node one should be one, for node two should be two, node three should be three, etc., etc. This way with No. You should start with one. Start with one.
The offset has to be
yeah. Okay. For if you are using custom index, which is not after increment, you should create your own unique pattern. Sorry. You should create your own unique pattern yourself. Okay, I will do this way. Should you create your own unique pattern yourself for each node and follow this pattern? So this is actually practically what you need to care when to be safe with asynchronous active setup. First, make sure you do not use unsafe statements. Bad practices for replication, which we have in user manual. Second, divide and rule and make sure each node writes exactly to the predefined number of objects. It's the objects which belongs to it, either tables, either databases, or split rows using some patterns. And conclusion, it's a hot setup, hot standby is easy to set up and maintain. It's you just need to care about you do not write into to servers in case if recovery happening to active node. For real active setups, separating writes by database table is comparatively easy to set up and maintain. Separating writes by row is challenging, but again, it can be done, and this way you can use this setup easily. More information is of all active links. This QR code, they are where works. Slides will be available on my SlideShare account and also on the conference website, and you can just click and follow. It's MySQL User Reference Manual. It's a webinar about troubleshooting MySQL replication. And this is a book, MySQL High Availability, by Chuck Bell, Lars Starman, and Matt Skindal. This is actually first book which accepted the fact that asynchronous replication and active setup is something which can be used in a real production environment and actually successfully used. It also has best practices how to do it safely. Thank you. And if you have questions, please ask. Yeah. Please. It's not a question. It's in MySQL cluster. We also have automatic conflict resolution. And do you speak about MySQL NDB cluster? It's about NDB cluster. Any other question? Please.
Writing to two different databases. Is it something you do on application level, or is it something you have a proxy up front?
It's up to you. You can do it on application level, or I think you can do it on the proxy SQL level too. Please.
Well, like suggestion, not a question. There is still article in Percona blog that says MySQL replication is a bad option. Might you consider to add your slides to this post as well?
So suggestion to add article about MySQL replication about is bad option, and I should consider to add it to my slides. So maybe for the next version. So thank you very much.
Some people still agree it's bad.
Some people still agree it's bad. Well, it's. Okay, so that's it.
Does anyone want to buy my seat for 20 euros?
Yes. Then.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.